Hello students, I, Mrs. Madhavi Mhatre, welcome you all in the next lecture of Mathematics 1. I hope all of you are doing well at home. Very soon we are going to have our first online assessment. And the portion for the same is chapter number 1, which we are studying. And very soon we are going to complete it. Okay, so the first online assessment will be MCQ basis. The questions will appear in the MCQ form. That means multiple choice questions will be there. For every question, you will have 4 different options and you have to write down the correct alternative from that. Okay. So start preparing for your exams. Now let us go further in this lecture. We are studying chapter number 1, sets, and in that we have completed all the topics. And in the previous lecture we have started with practice set 1.4. Okay, so from practice set 1.4, question number 1 was completed. Okay, it was very simple, straightforward question where we have used formula and then found out n of p. Okay, now according to the education ministry, there is a 25% reduction in the syllabus. Okay, when I will get the official PDF of that, then I will share the reduced syllabus with you. Okay, so let us go further in practice set 1.4. Question number 2 here is, in a hostel there are 125 students, out of which 80 drink tea, 60 drink coffee and 20 drink tea and coffee both. Find the number of students who do not drink tea or coffee. Okay, now let us try to understand the question. Here total number of students in the hostel are given. That means this is a universal set. And number of elements in universal set are 125. And there are two types of students. Some they drink tea and some they drink coffee. Okay. And some students they are drinking both the drinks. And there are certain students, those who are not taking any of the drink. Okay. They do not take tea or coffee. Okay. That means they are not taking any drink. Okay. So here now we will take those two sets as A and B. Suppose A is a set of students, those who drink tea, and B is a set of students, those who drink coffee. Okay, and then by reading the question, we will write down all the given information. Okay, so let us start with the solution. So here we will take two sets and universal set. Okay, so what we are going to do is that you be the universal set of all the students in the hostel, as I have said. Then A be the set of students drinking tea and B be the set of students drinking coffee. Now as I have said, we can solve every problem by using two different methods. First method is by using formula and second method is by using Venn diagram. But the beginning part, the introduction, is same for both. Okay, that means we are going to take set U, we are going to take set A and B, and describing those sets, that part is common to both the methods. Take a note of this. Okay, now from this information we can write down that U is 125. That means N of U is 125, we can write down. Number of students in universal set. Then the students, those who are drinking tea, how many are they? 80. So N of A is what? 80. And B is a set of students, those who are drinking coffee. So here it is given 60 drink coffee. So what we can write down? N of B is 60. And see further, 20 drink tea and coffee both. And word is there. I told you that whenever and word comes, we have to write intersection. Okay. That means N of A intersection B is equal to 20. Okay, so this is what we have written by using the given information. Now let us see what we have to find out. We have to find out the number of students who do not drink tea or coffee. Okay, so if you observe here, n of A is known, n of B is known, and n of A intersection B is known. So by using formula, we can find out n of A union B. Okay, what is n of A union B? The students who drink tea or coffee. Okay, and after getting that union, if we subtract it from the n of U, that means total number of students, then we are going to get the students, those who do not drink tea or coffee. Okay, so first of all, we have to find out n of A union B, and from that we can find out the thing which we want. Okay, so let us start solving it by using the formula. So first method is by using formula. All of you know that the formula is n of A union B is equal to n of A plus n of B minus n of A intersection B. This formula we already know. That is why we should write we have or we know that. Okay, now in this formula, the next thing is to substitute the values. So we can put the values. See, here n of A is 80, n of B is 60, and n of A intersection B is 20. So in the next step, we can write it like this. N of A union B is equal to 80 plus 60 minus 20. Okay, only the substitution. After writing the formula, that means our knowledge, we are substituting the values. So 80 plus 60 is 140, and 140 minus 20 is 120. So n of A union B is 120. That means the students, those who drink either tea or coffee, that is 120. And total number of students are how many? 125. So if we subtract 120 from 125, then we will get the number of students who do not drink tea or coffee. Okay, so we can write down. Therefore, the number of students who do not drink tea or coffee, that is equal to n of U minus n of A union B equal to 125 minus 120, that is 5. Okay, so this is method 1 where we are using the formula. Okay, so see here. After this information only, I wrote the word method 1. What does this mean is, this part is common to both the methods. You need to write down this part for both the methods. That means after reading the question, we are writing what is given to us. So that part is common to both the methods. I hope you must have copied down this. If you have not completed, you can pause the video and you can write it. Okay. Now let us go towards the second method, that is by using Venn diagram. So if you want to use that method, you need to write down this part in the beginning. Okay, so now I'm going on next slide. So keep in mind all these numbers. See, n of A is 80, n of B is 60, n of U means universal set here 125, and n of A intersection B is 20. Okay, so let us see the second method now. So method 2, by using Venn diagram. So the given information we will write by using the Venn diagram. As you know that universal set always we show by rectangle. So rectangle is drawn and it is written U is equal to 125. That means the number of students in the hostel is 125. Afterwards, inside that we have drawn two sets. Set A, the number of students, those who drink tea. And set B is the set of students, those who drink coffee. Okay, so what they have told is 20 students, they drink both the drinks. That is why in intersection part we wrote 20. And then for remaining part now, see n of A was what? 80. So 80 minus this intersection part, that is 60. That means this remaining part gives us 60. Similarly, here for B, we have total number of students as 60. So 60 minus 20, the common part. So it is 40. So what we can say here, we have three numbers. The first number is 60. That means the students, those who are drinking only tea. Then 20, the number of students, those who are drinking tea and coffee both. And 40 is the number of students, those who are drinking only coffee. Okay. Now you know that this complete part is A union B. That means by using this figure, we can find A union B. So we can write down here from figure A union B. That means this total part. How we are going to get 60 plus 20 plus 40. Correct? So I have written 60 plus 20 plus 40. That is 120. And now see, this is 125 and this remaining part X, suppose, is the number of students, those who are not drinking any of the drink. So after subtracting this union from the universal set, we are going to get the number of students, those who are not drinking tea or coffee, as N of U minus N of A union B. That means 125 minus 120 equal to 5. Okay. So in the first method, we are using formula. In the second method, we are using diagram. Now it's up to you that which method do you like. If you feel that by using formula only is comfortable for me, you can surely use that method. Somebody will think that Venn diagram is comfortable, so you can go for Venn diagram also. Okay. So now while writing also, if you want, you can write down both the methods, or you can follow a single method. If you feel that I will not go for Venn diagram, then don't write it down. Okay. But sometimes in exam, if it is specified that solve this problem by using Venn diagram only, then that time you cannot use the formula. You have to use Venn diagram only. But in our practice set, nowhere it is written that you use the specific method. So you can go for any method. Okay. So if you feel that first method is comfortable, write that method only. Ignore the second one. And those who feel that second is easy, you can ignore the first one and you can follow the second one. Okay. So it's up to you. Take the method whichever you like or whichever you feel is easy for you. So accordingly, you need to decide. Okay. So I hope you must have completed it along with me. Now let us go towards next question. Question number 3. In a competitive exam, 50 students passed in English, 60 students passed in mathematics, 40 students passed in both the subjects. None of them fail in both the subjects. Find the number of students who passed at least in one of the subjects. Okay, so this is little bit different question. Like in the previous question, we were having the concept of universal set. That means total number of students in the hostel. And from the two sets, tea and coffee, some were there, those who were not drinking any of the drink. But here, see this statement. None of them fail in both the subjects. That means here, whatever total students are there, they are same as the number of students in universal set. Okay, so here universal set and union is not different. In the previous question, it was different. So take a note of this. This statement, none of them fail in both the subjects. That means these all the students together, they give us universal set and it is same as the union also. That means union and universal set is not different here. Okay. So let us try to write down what is given here. So in a competitive exam, 50 students passed in English and 60 students passed in mathematics. So we will take set A as the set of students, those who passed in English, and set B as the set of students, those who passed in mathematics. Okay. So from this, we will get N of A as 50 and N of B as 60. And see, 40 students passed in both. When the both word comes, it denotes intersection. So what we can say is N of A intersection B is 40. And then we have to find out the number of students who passed at least in one subject. That means either in English or in mathematics. And when the word or comes, it denotes union. That means we have to find out the number of students in the union of these two sets. Okay. So So let us write down the given information, what is given to us. First of all, we will write down set A and set B, that let A be the set of students who passed in English and B be the set of students who passed in mathematics. See, writing this statement is compulsory. What set A denotes, what set B denotes. It's important. Okay. So from the given information, now what we can write down is N of A is 50. Because 50 passed in English. Then N of B is 60 because 60 students passed in mathematics. And 40 students passed in both. That means it's an intersection. So N of A intersection B is 40. And what we have to find out is the students who passed at least in one of the subjects. That means we have to find out N of A union B. Okay, so in first method, we have the formula which is very straightforward and you are going to get the answer directly. So, you will find that first method is easy. So, you can find it, write it here. You have to first write down that we know that and then write down the formula. N of A union B is equal to N of A plus N of B minus N of A intersection B. Then in next step, you need to substitute the values. So in place of N of A, you will write 50. In place of N of B, you will write 60. And in place of N of A intersection B, you will write 40. So you will get N of A union B as 50 plus 60 minus 40. So 50 plus 60 is 110 minus 40. The answer is 70. So, from that what we can write down is that 70 students passed at least in one subject. Or you can write down the number of students, those who passed at least in one subject are 70. So, simply you can write down the statement any way. But your final answer should appear like this as a statement because it carries half mark. If you are not writing final answer, then you will lose your half mark there. Okay. So, don't forget to write down this. I hope you must have understood this sum. Okay. Now, let us go towards the second method for this. That is by using Venn diagram. Okay. So, method 2, here also we are using Venn diagram. See, now we have not drawn rectangle because we don't have universal set here as I have said. So, set A and set B. The students, those who have passed in English is set A and students, those who have passed in mathematics is set B. And 40 students passed in both the subjects, that is why 40 is written in the intersection part. Then N of A is 50. That means this remaining part gives us 50 minus 40 equal to 10. See, N of A minus this intersection part. That is going to give you the remaining part of A. Similarly, for B, 60 minus 40 is equal to 20. And then you know that this total area gives us union. That means if we add these three numbers, 10, 40 and 20, then we are going to get N of A union B. That means the students, those who have passed in either of the subject. So we can write down N of A union B is equal to 10, see this is 10 plus 40 and 20. Okay, so take a note of this, how 10 has come. N of A is 50 minus the number of students in the intersection we have done. So 50 minus 40 is 10 and here also 60 minus 40 is 20. And while writing the union, we have taken the resultant numbers, that means 10, 40 and 20, that is 70. So therefore we can say that 70 students passed either in English or in mathematics. Okay, so you can solve it by any method. Now all of you can copy down this, and as I have said, if you feel that first method only is comfortable, don't write second method. If you feel that second method is good, don't write first method. So try to follow only one method. If you want, you can write both also. No problem. Now, let us go towards the next question. That is fourth one. A survey was conducted to know the hobby of 220 students of class 9th, out of which 130 students informed about their hobby as rock climbing and 180 students informed about their hobby as sky watching. There are 110 students who follow both the hobbies. Then how many students do not have any of the two hobbies? How many of them follow the hobby of rock climbing only? How many students follow the hobby of sky watching only? Okay, students, now what you can find is the up to this first question. This question is similar to the second one. That means here we are having the universal set, that means total number of students are 220. So here universal set is there. Why? Because some students, they do not have any of the hobbies. So there is a question in there is a difference in second, third and fourth question. So up to this you can find that the question is common to that second one. So universal set U we will take, and n of U is 220, that means number of students of class 9th, that is universal set. Then there are two types of students. Some are having the hobby of rock climbing and some are having hobby of sky watching. So those we will take as set A and set B. So we know n of A as 180 and n of B as, n of A is 130 and n of B is 180. And see, 110 students, they follow both the hobbies. That means this 110 is N of A intersection B. See, both words stands for intersection. Now, they have asked us to find the number of students, those who do not have any hobby. That means here, first we have to find out the number of students, those who have either of the hobby. Either means either rock climbing or sky watching. So when the word or comes, we have to find out N of A union B. So first we will find out N of A union B. And if we subtract it from the total students, then we will get the number of students who do not have any of the hobbies. Okay. So up to this, it is quite similar to the question number 2. But afterwards, they have given more questions. Two more questions are asked. How many of them follow the hobby of rock climbing only? And how many students follow the hobby of sky watching only? Okay. So for finding this hobby of rock climbing and hobby of sky watching, immediately you can get the answer from here. See, N of A is what? 130. So from that 130, if you subtract 110, that means 20. So 20 students, they have only the hobby of rock climbing. And from 180, if you subtract 110, that is 70, they have the hobby of sky watching. So answer of these two are quite ready in front of us. Only we have to find out this answer and then write them in sequence properly. That means we have to write down the answers in the proper sequence in which they are asked. So in the beginning, we will write down the description. What is universal set? What is set A? What is set B? So just write down that you be the universal set of all the students of class 9th. Then we will take set A. A be the set of students having rock climbing hobby and B be the set of students having sky watching hobby. So this is our description in the beginning, or we are going to denote what is U, what is A and what is B. Now afterwards, from the given information, we can write down like this: N of A is 130. That means 130 students, they have the hobby of rock climbing. So N of A is 130. Then 180 students have the hobby of sky watching. So N of B is 180. Then N of U, or simply you can write down U, is total students, that is 220, and 110 students follow both the hobbies. That means it gives us intersection. So N of A intersection B is 110. So this is what we can write down from the given information. Now, as I have said, to get the answer of the first question, we have to find out n of A union B first. So make use of the formula in method 1. So go for method 1, there you will write down the formula that n of A union B is equal to n of A plus n of B minus n of A intersection B. So n of A is 130, n of B is 180 and n of A intersection B is 110. So 130 plus 180 minus 110, that will give us n of A union B. Okay. So now see, 180 minus 110, if you do, you will get 70 here. And 130 plus 70 is 200. So n of A union B is 200. So we got n of A union B as 200. Now from this we can find out the number of students who do not have any of the two hobbies. So when we do 220 minus 200, we will get those students. Okay. So let us go further. So we will write down here, the number of students who do not have any of the hobbies is equal to n of u minus n of A union B. N of u we know 220 and n of A union B we found out just now, that is 200. So 220 minus 200, the answer is 20. So from this what we understood is 20 students do not have any of the two hobbies. Okay, then two more questions are asked. The number of students, those who have only rock climbing hobby. I told you that it is very easy to find. N of A minus N of A intersection B. That is given in question. So N of A is 130 minus N of A intersection B is 110. So here also the answer is 20. 20 students have only rock climbing hobby. Because 110 students, they follow both the hobbies. So we need to subtract. And similarly, we can get the answer for sky watching also. The number of students having only sky watching hobby is N of B minus N of A intersection B. So N of B is 180. So 180 minus 110, that is 70. Okay, so in this way, in sequence, you can write down answer of all the three questions asked. Okay, this is how we can solve it by first method. Now let us go towards the second method, that is Venn diagram. So see here, concept of universal set is there, therefore rectangle is drawn to denote the universal set, and u is equal to 220, total number of students. And in that we have drawn two circles to denote two sets, A and B. Set A is a set of students, those who have the hobby of rock climbing. And set B is the set of students, those who have the hobby of sky watching. So see, this intersection part means the number of students, those who have both the hobbies. So intersection is 110. So it is written here. And n of A is 130. So 130 minus 110, that is 20. The number of students, those who watch, those who have only hobby of rock climbing. And here also 180 minus 110, 70 students, those who have hobby of sky watching only. So directly you are getting the answer here in the Venn diagram. And this X gives us the number of students, those do not have any of the two hobbies. Okay, that means they neither like rock climbing, they neither like sky watching. Okay, so this number of students X, they do not have any of the hobby. So here also what we can say is that X be the number of students who do not have any hobby. Now here you know that all these together, see this 20, 110, 70 and X, together they are going to give us 220. Okay, so here you can write it like this, that X is equal to N of U minus N of A union B. So N of U is what? 220. And n of A union B is this part. You know that this total area, which is 20 plus 110 plus 70. Okay? This way you can write. Or simply if you write here from figure 20 plus 110 plus 70 plus x is equal to 220, then also you are right. Okay? You can do it directly also. But to get the value of x directly, I have written it like this. That how we are going to get x? N of u minus n of a union b. Okay? So 220 minus 200. If we add, we are going to get 200 here. And the answer is 20. So 20 students, they do not have any of the hobby. And then the remaining two answers, again you can write down in this way. Or directly also you can write down from here. That from figure, the students, those who do not have any of the two hobbies are 20. Because we have found it out here. So if you want, you can write in this way also. Or direct answer also you can write down from the figure. Okay, so the number of students who do not have any of the two hobbies that we have found out, 20. Then the number of students having only rock climbing hobby, that is n of A minus n of A intersection B. So 130 minus 110, that is 20 here. Okay, this part I have written again because I wanted to write down this statement. Okay. So, even if you don't write it again, it will do because we have found it out here. And then, the number of students having only sky watching hobby, they are n of b minus n of a intersection b. So, 180 minus 110, that is 70. So, I have specified here, I have written it again, but it is not compulsory to write. As I have said, direct answer also you can write down. Therefore, the number of students who do not have any of the two hobbies is equal to 20 because we have found it out here. The number of students, those who have only rock climbing hobby, is equal to 20 because from figure we can write it directly. And here also the number of students having only sky watching hobby is 70. Okay. So if you want to be more specific, you can write it down or you can write the direct answer also. Okay, students. So, I hope you must have understood these both the methods. Now, one question is remaining from this exercise that we will discuss in next lecture. So, students, today we are stopping here. Till that, you stay home, stay safe, take care of yourself. Thank you, students.